Hello everyone, this video is about creating and rotating the triangle about the origin and the fixed point. Initially we have declared the header files and the variables. Let us start tracing the program from the main. Argument counter and the argument variable are passed as a parameters to the main program. The value of the fixed points are passed in terms of x and y. By glutinit we are initializing argument counter and the argument variable. Glutinit display mode, double buffers and the color buffer is passed as parameters. Double buffer is used when the object is dynamic in nature. Double buffer, as the name suggests, have two buffers where one buffer is computing and other buffer is displaying. Once they finish their task, the buffer will swap each other. Glutinit window size is used to set the size of the viewing window. Glutinit window position is used to set the position of the viewing window. By default, it is the left top corner of the monitor. If we want to change its position, we can do it by changing the parameter. Glut create window is used to give the name to the window. Let us go to the myInit function. GL clear color is used to clear the background color and give a new color to the background. Here, as we have passed red, green, blue values as 0, 0, 0 respectively, we are giving a black color to the background. GL projection mode is selected as a matrix mode. GL load identity is used to multiply a matrix with the identity matrix. GLU ortho 2D is used because the triangle is a two dimensional and the values are passed for left, right, bottom and top respectively. Projection mode is then converted to model view. Next we have a display function. Let us now trace a display function. GL clear is used to clear the color buffer to avoid the mixing of colors with the colors already present in the color buffer. GL load identity is to multiply it with the identity matrix so that the color will remain identical. R flag values identifies whether to rotate a triangle about the origin or a fixed point or to stop the rotation. R flag value is equal to 1 to rotate about the origin. So the value of x and y coordinate is set to 0,0. If R value is 2, we are rotating the triangle about the fixed point. The fixed point coordinates are set to x and y values. Next is draw pixel function. Let us now trace a draw pixel function. Draw pixel function is used to draw the point. GL color 3F is used to give color to the point. Here, as only a blue color value is 1, the color of a point is blue. The point size is used to set the size of the point. GL begin is for the primitives. GL point is used to draw a point. GL vertex 2F x, y is used to set the x coordinate for the point. To rotate a triangle about a fixed point, we are using the CTM method, that is current transformation matrix method. The triangle in an affine space is translated to an origin and then rotated by an angle and then again translated back to the affine space. Next is a triangle function. Let us now trace triangle function. Triangle function is used to draw a triangle. GL color 3F is used to give the color to the triangle. As only a value of a red color is 1, the triangle is red in color. GL triangle is used to draw a triangle. As the three vertices are required to draw a triangle, the XY coordinates for these three vertices is passed by using three GL vertex 2F functions. Glut pose redisplay is the function used to redraw a triangle. Glut swap buffer is a function used to swap a two buffers. Coming back to our main function, we have a glut create menu, which is used to create a menu and give a name to it. Here we are creating a menu and named as a rotate menu. Let us trace a rotate menu function. Void rotate menu is used to set a values for R flag. If a option is equal to 1, R flag value is set to 1, which means rotate a triangle about the origin. If a option is equal to 2, R flag value is set to 2, which means rotate a triangle about the fixed point. If a option is equal to 3, R flag value is set to 3, which means to stop the triangle rotation. Next, in a main, we have glut add menu entry, which is used to add a selectable option to a menu. Here, three options given are rotate about the origin, rotate about a fixed point, and stop the rotation. Next, we have a glut attach menu, which is used to attach a menu to a right button of the mouse. Then we have a glut main loop, which is used to loop a main function so that the output can be seen for a certain amount of a time. This is the entire program.
Okay guys, now let's run the code and see the output. So I have already copy pasted the code what we traced before. Now I'll compile and there's no error. So I'll run the code. So before it asked for a fixed point, since the window position what we have given is 500, the fixed point should be within that. So I'll give 100 and 150. Yeah, this is the output what we get. If we right click, we'll get the option that is rotate around origin, rotate around fixed point and stop rotation. This is the what menu we have given. So if I click on the rotate around origin, so the triangle will rotate around the origin that the origin you have given as a draw pixel. And the color what we have given for that point is blue. So this shows how the first option will go. And if we go for rotate around fixed point, so this is the fixed point what we have given, that is 100 and 150, and the triangle will rotate around it. And if we go for the third option, that is stop rotation, the rotation of the triangle will stop there. So now let's change few points in the program and we'll see what output we'll get. So since we had used a double buffer, we'll take as a single buffer. Let's make changes in the program and we'll see what output we will get. So we have used a double buffer. Let's see what output we will get for a single buffer. Okay, I have changed it for single. And if we use single, then we have to give as GL flush. But I'm not going to change it now. I'll see whether we'll get the output or not. So I have compiled the code. I hope we won't get any errors now. Yeah, there's no error. It's not showing any errors for it. So I'll run the code. Like before, it's asking for a fixed point. So I'm giving the same. Okay, now we are not getting the output since we have used single buffer and we are not giving as GL flush. We are not getting the output. So I'll change it to GL flush. I have given as GL flush now. So I have used single buffer and GL flush. So I'll compile the code. Okay, there's no error. So I'll run it. Again, it's asking for a fixed point. Okay, now we got the output. So it's same options. So the output is similar for what we got it before. The draw pixel what we have given in this code is actually optional. It's only for the reference of the point. So I'll just comment it and see what output we will get. I'll see whether we'll get the output or not. So I'm going to comment it, the draw pixel which we had called in the display. So now I'll run the code. And there's no error again. So I'll run the code. I'm giving the fixed point a same. So I'm getting the output. So I'm not getting this blue point what we were getting before, because I have commented the draw pixel, so it's not calling that function. Since we had given blue color to that, I'll show it the code. So I have given the blue color for the point. So we are commenting the draw pixel, so it's not calling this function, so it's not showing in the output. And the last changes what I want to show is what happens if we comment the GL flush, whether we will get the output or not. So I'll comment this and we'll run the code and we'll see whether we'll get the output or not. We are not getting any errors. It's not showing any errors. So we can run the code now. It's asking for the fixed point. Okay, we are not getting the output because GL flush is necessary, since GL flush is used to display. If we comment it, then we won't get the output. So yeah, so this is the program. I hope you understood. If you have any queries, please let us know with your comments below. Please like the video, subscribe to our channel, and thank you for watching.